गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ अमन जोशी। आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। पढ़ाई अच्छी चल रही होगी फ्रेंड्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस टू मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्ट्स, दैट इज़ 1919 एंड 1935। दीज एक्ट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। फ्रेंड्स, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब्ड येट, सो दैट यू कैन गेट ऑल नोटिफिकेशंस रिगार्डिंग माई न्यू लेक्चर्स। फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट। Its objective was the gradual introduction of responsible government in India. Friends, Britishers for the first time on August 20, 1917 declared that they want to introduce responsible government in India. This act is also known as Montagu-Chelmsford reforms. Why Montagu-Chelmsford reforms? Because Edwin Montagu was Secretary of State and Lord Chelmsford was Viceroy of India. Friends, it separated central and provincial subjects. What structure of government is unitary? The central and provincial legislatures were authorized to make laws on their respective list of subjects, but structure of government is unitary. Friends, it divided provincial subjects into transferred and reserved. Transferred subjects were to be administered by the governor with the aid of ministers responsible to the legislative council, and the reserved subjects also administered by the governor and his executive council, but in this it is not responsible. Governor is not responsible to the legislative council. Friends, this system, this scheme of governance is also known as diarchy. Diarchy means double rule. You know, I have discussed it in the previous lectures, but this system was not successful. So friends, next is introduced bicameralism and direct elections. Friends, bicameralism means two houses, like in present Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha in center, and in states legislative council and legislative assembly. So it introduced bicameralism. And friend, direct election. By direct election we means that it is a system of choosing political office holders in which the voters directly cast ballots for the person or persons or political party that they desire to see elected. Friends, it is the largely used election, direct election, because we know that in general elections we use this system, like election of MPs, MLAs and member of local bodies. I think you know local bodies. Local bodies are panchayats and municipalities. Okay. So friends, indirect election kya hota hai? What is indirect election? It is an election in which voters do not choose between candidates for an office, but elect people who then choose. For example, presidential election, because we choose MPs, MLAs, and they vote for the president. Okay friends, so next point is Indian Legislative Council was replaced by a bicameral legislature consisting of an upper house, that is Council of States, and a lower house, that is Legislative Assembly. The majority of members of both the houses were chosen by direct election. Clear hai? Friends, next point is it required that the three of the six members of the Viceroy's Executive Council, other than the Commander-in-Chief, were to be Indian. It means that three members were Indians, but among them, Commander-in-Chief were not to be Indian. It is Britisher. Friends, it extended the principle of communal representation by providing separate electorates for six Indian Christians, Anglo-Indians and Europeans. Friends, if you remember, I discussed with you in 1909, communal representation was given to Muslims. Okay, now this is extended to six Indian Christians, Anglo-Indians and Europeans. It granted franchise, that is voting rights, to a limited number of people on the basis of property, tax or education. And franchisee, you know, it is an election, it is voting rights. It is related to voting rights. It created a new office of the High Commissioner for India in London and transferred some functions to him that are performed by the Secretary of State for India. So next point is, it provided for the establishment of a PSC, that is Public Service Commission. Hence, a Central Public Service Commission was set up in 1926 for recruiting civil servants on the recommendations of Lee Commission. Friends, Lee Commission is appointed during the tenure of 1923 and 24. Lee Commission on Superior Civil Services in India. Friends, it separated provincial budgets from central budgets and authorized provincial legislatures to enact their budgets. Okay, clear? It provided for the appointment of a statutory commission to inquire into and report on its working after 10 years of its coming into force. So friends, they have provided that har 10 saal ke baad ek statutory commission appoint ki jayegi jo ki batayegi ki bhai kya progress hui hai is act mein, kya changes hone chahiye. But Britishers didn't wait. They introduced Simon Commission. They appointed Simon Commission before the scheduled time, before 2 years. The British government announced the appointment of a 7-member statutory commission under the chairmanship of Sir John Simon to report on the condition of India under its new constitution. And all the members were British, and hence all parties boycotted the commission. Friends, this commission submitted its report in 1930 and recommended the abolition of diarchy, extension of responsible government in the provinces, establishment of a federation of British India and princely states, continuation of communal electorate, and so on. So these are the changes they want, that these should be these changes should be applied in the next act. Friends, to consider the proposals of the commission, the British government convened 3 roundtable conferences of the representatives of the British government and Indian princely states. Friends, out of 3 roundtable conferences, only Gandhiji represented Congress. He attended 1 roundtable conference, that is second RTC roundtable conference. And it is due to the Gandhi-Irwin Pact between Gandhiji and Lord Irwin. And Gandhiji made some demands in the British Parliament in the roundtable conference, but they had not accepted the demands of Gandhiji, so that the result was failed. Friends, white paper on constitutional reform was prepared. Roundtable conferences, jo bhi natije nikle, they prepared a white paper on constitutional reforms. The recommendations were incorporated in the next government of Act of 1935. So friends, all the recommendations which Simon Commission has introduced, they were incorporated in the next Government of India Act of 1935. The result of 3 roundtable conferences was Communal Award in 1932 by Ramsay MacDonald. Friends, Ramsay MacDonald is British Prime Minister at that time. He announced a scheme of representation of the minorities, which came to be known as Communal Award. Friends, this Communal Award not only continued separate electorates for the Muslims, Sikhs, Indian Christians, Anglo-Indians, and Europeans, but also extended it to the depressed classes, that is scheduled castes. Gandhiji was distressed over this extension of the principle of communal representation to the repressed classes, and he undertook fast in the Yerawada jail, fast unto death, to get the award modified. And friends, at last there was an agreement between the leaders of the Congress and the repressed classes. There was an agreement between the Gandhiji and B.R. Ambedkar, and this agreement is known as Pune Pact. So whenever a question regarding communal award is asked in an examination, you must remember some key points, like communal award is related with Gandhiji, depressed classes. These are key points which help you to remember things. And key points are depressed classes, Gandhiji, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Pune Pact, Yerawada Jail, McDonald, British PM, who announced this communal award. So friends, if you remember all the 5 to 6 key points, it will help you to understand better and mark the correct answer in the examination. So friends, this is all about Government of India Act of 1919. So let's start Government of India Act of 1935. Friends, let us discuss the features of Act of 1935. It provides for establishment of an All India Federation. It divided powers between center and units in terms of three lists, that is federal list for center with 59 items, provincial list for provinces with 54 items, and concurrent list for both with 36 items. Friends, concurrent list is that list in which those subjects are covered which are not covered in federal lists and provincial list. Okay. Then residuary powers to Viceroy, what federation never came into being because princely states did not join. This federation never came into being. So friends, there you understand what is residuary powers. Residuary powers are those powers which are given to Viceroy only. That is, Viceroy only can make laws with regard to any subjects. So residuary powers were given to Viceroy. If we look at our Indian Constitution, residuary powers were given to Parliament under Article 248(2) of the Indian Constitution. Under this, Parliament can make any law with respect to any matter that is not enumerated in List 1 and 3. So friends, next point is, it abolished diarchy in the provinces and introduced provincial autonomy in its place. It introduced responsible government in provinces. Abolish kar di gayi diarchy provinces mein aur uski jagah par provincial autonomy lai gayi. Okay, next point is, it provided for the adoption of diarchy at the center, but this provision did not come into operation. Next is, introduced bicameralism in 6 out of 11 provinces. 6 provinces mein bicameralism introduced kiya gaya. It provided separate electorates to SCs, women and laborers. In the Act of 1909, separate electorate is provided to SCs in the communal award. But in this act, it extended to women and laborers also. And friends, next point is, abolished the Council of India established by the Government of India Act of 1935. Under this act, it abolished Government of India Act, Council of India, sorry. Extended franchisee to 10% of total population. Establishment of RBI provided for establishment of not only a federal PSC, but also provincial PSC and joint PSC. Means Public Service Commission. Friends, joint PSC is for 2 or more states. Provided for the establishment of federal court set up in 1937 with original, appellate and advisory jurisdiction. So friends, what is original, what is appellate and what is advisory jurisdiction? Let I discuss with you briefly. Friends, original jurisdiction is jurisdiction of a court or the power of the court to hear a case for the first time. Means it has the power to hear the case at first instance. That is its original jurisdiction of the court. And appellate jurisdiction, it means when a higher court has the power to review a lower court's decision. That is appellate. For example, koi faisla aata high court mein, then the person moves to against the order of the high court to Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has appellate jurisdiction. Even High Court also has appellate jurisdiction. Means any lower court's decision can be challenged in higher court, and the higher court has appellate jurisdiction. Now next is advisory jurisdiction. Friends, This provision finds its origin in section 213 of the Government of India Act of 1935, which conferred upon the Governor General the discretion to pose question of public importance to the federal court. Similarly, as per Article 143 in the Indian Constitution, the President has the power to address questions to the Supreme Court, which he deems important for public welfare. Means ki agar president chahe to kisi bhi prakar ki salah agar use koi law point ke related koi help chahiye to wo supreme court se madad le sakta hai, advice le sakta hai. That is the advisory jurisdiction. Okay friends, supreme court jo hamara india ka tha, it came into being on 28 January 1950. It replaced both the Federal Court of India, which is in the British time, and the Judicial Committee of the Privy Council, which were at the apex of the Indian court system at that time. Okay, so I think friends, you understand what is original, appellate and advisory jurisdiction. If you still have any questions, please write in the comment box and I will try my best to clear your all doubts. So friends, thank you very much for watching the lesson. If you like it, please share and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.